So, dear brothers and sisters, that as we have rejoiced at the nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, so by leave of God's mercy, we announce to you also the joy of his resurrection, who is our Savior. On the 17th day of February will fall Ash Wednesday, and the beginning of the fast of the most sacred Lenten season. On the 4th day of April, you will celebrate with joy Easter Day, the Paschal Feast of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the 16th day of May will be the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the 23rd day of May, the Feast of Pentecost. On the 16th day of June, the Feast of the Most Holy Body and Blood of Christ. On the 28th day of November, the first Sunday of the Advent of our Lord Jesus Christ, to whom is honor and glory forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, so that we may prepare ourselves to worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Thank you.
O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds covers the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow. For the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian, Ephah, all from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, have mercy.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea. For thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. As I was walking through my regular walk one day before Christmas, I walked past one of the houses around in the neighborhood, and it had several of those big blow-up, light-up Christmas decorations, you know, the huge Santa or the huge big snowman, and it all looked very, very festive and joyful. Well, the day after Christmas, I went for a walk, kind of taking the same path, and all those blow-up decorations were turned off, they were deflated, and were nothing more than just a lump of plastic in the front yard. And I don't know about you, but as I walked past that, I thought to myself, sometimes that's what it's like after Christmas is over. We spend all this time preparing for it, and then boom, it's over almost in an instant. Now, it's like that in normal years, but this one, while it was still Christmas, actually it gave us something to look forward to kind of take our minds off what was going on. But when the day is over, it's over. And so there is a certain amount of letdown. And it's like all the air was let out of us. And suddenly the excitement is gone of what we've been anticipating, and life usually goes back to normal. But this year, what is normal? We don't know. But at least we got a day or two, hopefully not absorbed in all the bad news. Now, I know for myself, as a priest, and even after doing it for 29 years, I always get so keyed up and excited for the Christmas Masses, as I love Christmas Mass. It was my first Catholic Mass ever to attend as a child was Midnight Mass, and that's when one of the times I knew I wanted to become a Catholic. Well, this year, I had 5 Christmas Masses. But after all that, you know, then you get so keyed up. For me, and I think other priests too, Christmas Day is always kind of after the last Mass, it's a big downer. It's like, well, okay, now what? And it always is, but this year I think it was kind of worse. And then the day after Christmas, I was at CBS, and they had these guys out there grabbing Christmas decorations and throwing them in a cart, and there was another guy following right behind and putting up Valentine's Day decorations. So while Christmas is over in the world, they're moving on to the next holiday. But Christmas Day, the Christmas carols and the songs stop in the secular world. The Hallmark Christmas movies went till the first, but now they're gone too. But there's always a natural kind of letdown after Christmas. And yet it always seems kind of odd and countercultural that here in church we're still singing Christmas carols. The decorations are still up, albeit wilting by the day. They're still up. But Christmas is not over yet. In much of the world, it is not over until Epiphany. And in other places, like when I lived in Italy, the Christmas season goes until the Feast of the Presentation of the Lord on February the 2nd. But here in our country, for the most part, at least in the church, it's really the Christmas season is over at Epiphany, which is today. And today, well, actually it's the 6th, but we're celebrating it today. Today we celebrate the Feast of the Epiphany of the Lord, when the three kings, or the three wise men, or the magi, they came to the stable to see the Christ child. And they followed, as we heard, the star, and they presented him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, which in those days, well, gold still is very precious, but frankincense and myrrh were very precious gifts that you would give to someone. But we know, because of reading in the gospel, that they were sent under kind of sneaky false pretenses. Herod sent them, saying that he wanted to go and do homage to the child as well, but he sent them because he was jealous, and he felt threatened by the birth of Christ, because he wondered what all this was going to be and how Jesus was going to affect him or take down his power. And so he saw him as a threat. And so he sent the three to find the child, and as we know, they were supposed to go back and tell him where Jesus was. But when they saw Jesus, they realized what they had seen and that this was a special child. And so, as we heard in a dream, they did not go back and tell Herod where he was. But I think the gospel really reflects kind of the complexity of Christmas. The three magi, when they were in the presence of Jesus, it was overwhelming. It was awesome. It was joyous. And yet they knew that that moment would not last forever, and they couldn't stay there forever. But the word Epiphany means a manifestation of God. And so the shepherds had that ultimate manifestation of seeing the Son of God in the flesh. Herod, on the other hand, was unhappy, threatened, and jealous. He was threatened, like I said, of what Jesus might bring to the world. So what he thought would make him happy was to find Jesus and to stop him or to kill him. But he couldn't, at least at that moment. Lots of times, I think, in life, the things that we think will make us happy, maybe popularity or possessions and things like that, they really don't, but we spend our lives searching for them. But they don't make us that happy at the end of the day. But it's the deep things like love and friendship and family and faith, those are the things that truly make lasting happiness. And Christmas gives us the gift of all kinds of emotions. love, joy, happiness. Yet for some, especially this year with the isolation, Christmas is sad. For some people, there's a lot of jealousy that maybe their Christmas isn't like somebody else's or maybe like the kind they used to have. Certainly a Zoom Christmas dinner is not the same as being there in person. Yet for some, like I said, Christmas, it's a relief the day that it's over. I've known people that it's like, oh, I'm glad it's over, put the decorations away Christmas evening. But last year, interesting, on the Feast of the Holy Family, I got a phone call from a man, his infant son, well, the son didn't call, but the man, his wife and infant son, and they were homeless and they were stranded. They had nowhere to go. And I thought, okay, this is kind of odd that a family would call me out of the blue on the Feast of the Holy Family, and with a mother, a child, and an infant. I thought, is God testing me? Is this a test? So I better follow through. And so I found them a motel. But their Christmas wasn't all that great, but at least there was some room for them in the end. But in reality, Christmas brings out all kinds of emotions. We know that. But while the Feast of Christmas is just really a few weeks out of the year, the blessings of Christmas never end. And the only way they'll ever end is if we choose to end them. When the three followed the star, what they found was way more than they could have ever expected. Not only did they find a baby in a manger, also they found their hearts. And their hearts were filled with love. And they knew that they should not do what Herod had wanted them to do, and so they did not. Suddenly, they not only followed the stars, but they followed their hearts and their conscience. And so if we let ourselves follow the star of faith, we too can find way more than we expected. And faith can get us through just about anything that life may throw at us, because we're walking with the Lord. And the ultimate epiphany or manifestation of God or the Son of God is right here in Christ's body, blood, soul, and divinity that we receive every time we come to the altar. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now let us bring our prayers to the Lord.
For the Holy Catholic Church, that we may welcome all who seek peace and truth into our fold, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the nations of the world in shadows, that all rulers may be drawn to the dawning brightness of Jesus Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a universal charity, that all bigotry, narrowness, and racism may be driven from our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of humble worship in our lives, that we may adore Jesus in the Eucharist with a devotion of the wise men who brought gifts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our departed loved ones, especially Jackie Medley, that God may grant them peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our own personal intentions, we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Almighty God, we ask you to hear these prayers and those that we hold in our hearts. Continue to show us your mercy and your love. And we ask this all through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church. Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which are offered now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed, and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true, celebrating the most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, eternal with you in your glory, appeared in a human body, truly sharing our flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hand, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, in the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servant, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Remember especially Michael Carabelli. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you. Please stand. For the end of this pandemic and all the damage that it is causing. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Blessed Stanley Rother. Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.